A square column 400 mm by 400 mm is reinforced with 4 bars of 20 dia. The cover is given as 40 mm. This is clear cover, so effective cover will be clear cover plus diameter by 2, that is 20 by 2, which is 50 mm. M20 concrete and Fe415 steel are used. Neutral axis XU is 600 mm away from the highly compressed edge, that is XU from highly compressed edge is 600 mm, where RD is 400 mm, so XU is greater than D. Let us say this is level 1, where our reinforcement which is present at least compressed edge and reinforcement present as highly compressed edge is say level 2. To find force in level 2 bars, which is compressive force in bars, we need to find strain in that bars first at that level. So strain in bars at that level, say epsilon 2, this is epsilon 1. Epsilon 2 is given as 0.002 into XU minus D by 2 minus Y1 by XU minus 3/7 of D, where Y1 is the distance to the level of steel present from the center line of the column, which is equal to, since the effective cover is 50, this total is 200, so Y1 will be 150 mm. Y1, take this way as positive and this way as negative 4, so our Y1 now will be negative. Substituting 0.002 into XU 600 minus D by 2 is 400 by 2 minus of minus 150 by XU is 600 minus 3/7 of D is 400, then epsilon 2 will be obtained as 0.0026. Given corresponding to the strain value, stresses are given. Our strain is 0.0026, which is present between 0.00241, for which our stress value FSC is 342. For 0.0026, we don't know the strain. 0.00276, the stress value is given as 351. On interpolating, stress corresponding to 0.0026 will be obtained as 346.885 Newton per mm square. So the force in bars present at two level will be stress in those bars into area of bars, that is equal to 346.885 into 2 bars of 20 dia are present, so 2 into each 20 dia bar area is 314, so that will be equal to 217.8 kilonewtons, which is nearly 218 kilonewtons. So our option is C.